Hello students, so welcome you back in the lecture series of software engineering, and today's topic is low level design, where we will discuss about the modularization and design structure. The topics that is contained in these slides are low level design, modularization in software cost, and structure chart. So before discussing the low level design, we have already discussed about the architectural design and the high level design. Okay, so architectural design is the structure, basic structure of your software, and the high level design is to give them the form of processes. Okay, so high level design is kind of all over the structure of your software to identify the modules or subsystems. Okay, so in the low level design, we are trying to give them a detailed solution. The process that we have defined in the high level design, of those high level design processes, detailed solution is mentioned in this low level design. What kind of data structure we using to solve the problem, and what is the algorithm of each and every module. So micro based level design or detailed design is mentioned in the low level design. So the outcome of this low level design is documented in the form of module specification documentation. Okay, so as we know, the micro level or detailed level give the description of each and every module, okay, including their logic, what kind of condition they will use, what are the loops they will have. Okay, so total solution of high level design is mentioned into the low level design. Okay, so if we have mentioned some process in the high level design, then the process detailed design is mentioned in the low level design, including the data structure, what is their algorithm. Okay, so what are the functions you are using. Okay, so this is known as a low level design. The next is your modularization. Modularization, first we know what is module. Okay, so when you have gather all the requirement from the customer, okay, you have done the requirement analysis, that is outcome you have, which is known as your SRS document. After your SRS document, you go for the architectural design. When you have done the architectural design, you have the high level design. After the high level design, you have the low level design. Okay, so module is to divide your system into small part. Okay, small entity. That small entity is very important. The small entities work independently. Okay, so there are one software which contain multiple number of module, and each module can work independently. Okay, so what is the benefit of this modularization? That it is easy to implement. When we have to develop a single entity, then it is easy to us to develop. When we have to develop the whole software, it is quite typical. Okay, so solution is easy, implementation is easy, debugging is easy. Okay, error detection is easy, testing is easy. That means if there is any error into a module, you can easily find out. Okay, imagine you have 10 modules in a software, and you are testing them independently, and you are not getting the correct answer from module 5. So now you are clear in your mind that only module 5 is not logically correct, otherwise all the modules are working fine. So that's why I'm saying that testing is easy, documentation is easy. Maintenance part, you want to change something in your software, you want some modification, then you go for the particular module. You doesn't have to change all the software, you will change into the particular module which has to change, okay, or which need change. Okay, so modularization is to divide your software into a small entity. Okay, so in some programming languages, library is also referred as a module. Okay, When I am talking about the C++ or Java has a classes, there is Java packages. In C and Pascal, there are procedures and function. For Fortran, there are the subroutines are available. Multiple packages are included. The multiple packages which are using by the user. Okay, those libraries are known as the module. Okay. So you those module are pre-written codes. Okay. So you can use those pre-written codes for your software. So imagine you have to do the sorting. Okay. So you can use a sorting package. Okay. So you need sorting. You have sorting package. You can directly use that package and sort the array. You doesn't need have to use every time a sorting algorithm to sort an array. Okay, so this is the advantages of modularization. That means reusability. As I already told in the last example, that there are 10 problems and you have to sort the array. So you can use a sorting array one package for all 10 arrays. I hope you are able to understand. Just let me write it down. You have 10 problems, or I can say 10 arrays for sorting. Okay, and it means you have to sort 10 times. That means you doesn't have to write the sorting code for the 10 times. You can write it one time and use that code or function for each and every one function for sort, solution. You can use for this, or any of them. Okay, so sorting code, the sorting code solution you have to write only one time. Okay, so reusability. Okay, so by using the reusability, you can minimize the duplication. Okay, the complexity of the problem will reduce. Okay, improve the manageability. That means if you have multiple number of module, you can easily manage which module has problem. Error detection and error removation is very easy to handle. Okay, so these are the benefits of the modularization. Okay, this is very important graph. How will you decide that how many number of modules is perfect for your software? Okay, imagine you have any software and you have to divide into the number of module. Then how will you decide that 10 or 11 or 15, whatever the number of module is sufficient or correct for your software? So the common answer is, if the integration cost, if the integration cost is increases by the division of module, then only then we doesn't have to divide into the module. Okay, so I hope you will know after this graph. So here is the cost of effort. Cost of effort means the time for the cost of development of the code and the number of module. Okay, so as the number of module will increase, the effort cost will decrease. Okay, as the cost number of module will increase, imagine I can take an example. Imagine you have to write a book. Okay, so there is some cost on effort. If you divide your book into the number of chapter, and so you have decided the number of module. Imagine you have to write 10 chapters. So you have divided into the 10 chapter. As number of chapters will increase, the cost of effort will decrease. Okay. The next point is very important, is cost of integration. After developing each and every module, after writing each and every chapter, you have to integrate them. Okay, as number of module are increases, cost of integration is also increases. Okay, if cost of integration increases, then total cost of software will increase. I hope you are able to understand. Then effort is inversely proportional to the number of module. So if number of module are increases, then definitely effort will decrease. Okay, but as module is increases, cost of integration will increase. If cost of integration increase, then total cost of software will increase. So we have to check that as the this is the reason I am mentioning into the green. This is the reason where you get the minimum cost. How? Where the cost of this. We have to manage in such a condition the cost of effort will not minimize as the number of module will not maximize, because we have to manage in somewhere in middle. Okay, so the cost will not increase exponentially. The cost will have their amount, as we have discussed financially. So this is the amount, this is the right amount where the number of module and the cost of effort is settled down. Okay, I hope it is very important that we have to divide number of module in such a way that integration cost will not increase from the total cost of the software. Okay, I am erasing all the ink so you can easily write it down. It is very important graph. Okay, so next topic is structure chart. Structure chart is to mention the hierarchical structure of your module. You have discussed many modules, so structure chart is to define as a black boxes. Black boxes means is kind of a boxes where the detail function is not mentioning, so inner details is unknown for the user. So he has to generate outputs by giving some inputs. Okay, so when you give input to the system, you get the output. Sometimes the output is expected, as you know, sometimes the output is not expected. Here we are breaking our system into the smallest entity. Okay, lowest function module, by which we can easily understand the detailing of the system. Okay, so structure chart has construction by different symbols where we use module, conditional call, loops, data flows, control flow and physical storage. So module is decided in three types, where control module, sub module and library module. Control module is act as a super one where has connected to the more than one sub module, and sub module are the part of the another module. Okay, so module basically are the codes. Modules are the code that are independently run. Okay, and library module are reusable module that can be invoked by any other module if they need it. Okay, so next is conditional call. So control module will select any of them, whether the submodule 1 or whether the submodule 2, depending on the mentioned condition. Imagine if I am taking some example, if A is greater than 75, then we will go for the submodule 1, true or false, otherwise we will go on submodule 2. So which submodule is select from the control module is based on some condition, that is known as a conditional call. Okay, next is your loops. So the repetitive execution of submodule. Imagine control module have a different submodule. Okay, if they need a repetitive execution of any module dependent on some condition, so by the loop we can do that. Okay, next is your data flow. how the data will flow between the module separated by the directed arrow. Okay, one more thing I want to mention, because it is very important, with the end with the circle. This is very important. How will you mention? You will represent the direction of the arrow and with the empty circle. This particular, I am mentioning in the color green, this particularly mention the flow of data. We are discussing the representation of the structure chart. Okay, in the control flow, only the direction arrow, okay, with the circle which is filled, the circle is filled color. Okay, the two things I am mentioning, the circle which has empty is mentioned the data flow, the circle which is filled color is mentioning the control flow. Okay, I hope you are understanding. I am mentioning again as an arrow, this arrow is mentioning the data flow, and this arrow completely filled end circle mentioning the control flow. Okay, so next is your physical storage, where all the data and the information stored, okay, in the physical storage is mentioning like that. Okay, so I hope you are able to understand what is low level design, what is modularization, and modularization, how will you decide how many modules is needed in your software. Okay, the design structures. Okay, structure chart are the notation by which you can decide the module control flow, data flow, and the conditional calls. Okay, thank you so much.